is over, and I would wanna take you traveling the world. But I can love you, yeah, I'm gonna love you. I'll give you the world of what I've got, the fancy finds, baby, I have not. Just gonna love you.
December. A month not popularized by high rutting action, but it's there. The second breeding season, where younger does come into heat, sparks a smaller rut cycle that, when timed correctly, can lead to some hot action. Once the pressure from the gun opener cools off, deer begin to move again in daylight. Hoping to capitalize on this, I head back to Spencerport with my bow sitting over the clearing plot.
Thank you.
High winds would start that afternoon, making it a tad unsafe to be in a tree. I would go out the next morning, but no movement. Throughout the entire fall, there has been one property I have yet to hunt, and that is out south of Buffalo. On the 11th, I would travel out there to check on cameras I had left up around the plot. I run into a large doe group on my walk up. Once able to check my cards, I discovered the full effect that small plot had on that piece. It was impressive to see not only a trophy caliber buck, but also how early in the season bucks were around and how often deer were visiting the plot. I wanted to try and get a sit in, but it would have to wait. After my run-in with this buck on the 4th, I hoped that I would see some more second rut action back in Spencerport. This morning, the dog come into the clearing this morning from Obviously a slob did not come by. The 12th was the last day of firearm season, and now late season archery and muzzle loader was up. Another first for New York is that this late season would end on the 21st, but reopen on the 26th and close January 2nd. This will be the latest any deer hunter could hunt, to my knowledge, ever in New York. I would keep out of the woods until the holiday hunt, which is what it's called, where I would get 6 days to try and fill at least one more tag.